So Micaiah, these are some of the myths that were that have been debunked here. And I want to ask you, when do you think media loses all of its legitimacy? I'm really happy to watch mainstream media die. And I'm happy that it's happening slowly because I'm glad to watch it suffer.
I agree.
Yeah. This is fun. It's fun watching Brian Stelter every Sunday. Like, we have to get rid of alternative shows on Facebook and Twitter. It's the plague of America. Don't ask how I got this job. Super straight. Every single week, they're on there saying that people like us need to be removed, that we're the greatest threat to our concept. They say democracy, but they constitutional republic. They don't know that.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So they went with these claims with Columbus, which happened yesterday. And a lot of you believed these. And when we reported this yesterday, we even had to say, hey, look, people are reporting that she called the cops. Micaiah, I forget the name. I don't know. M. They are reporting that her aunt claimed. We were very clear on that because we said we didn't know, but we did have the body cam footage, which was the most concrete evidence.
Yeah.
NPR and Daily Beast and CNN didn't do that. That's the issue here is there's a lie or misinformation that goes out. And I would say it's a lie if you don't check your sources because you simply want to push a story that perpetuates a narrative. I would say that's a lie because you have all of these tools at your disposal to double check your sources and then not follow up with the truth. So let's go through a couple of claims here. One of them was that Micaiah was defending herself. Right. This is defending herself against other girls who were abusing her. That's one of the claims that went
out. The other girl did have a small dog.
Yes.
Very scary dog.
They are terrible.
Yes,
and dogs are scary.
God only knows what she was hiding in those skin tight pink sweatpants.
That's true.
Anything. She could have a Glock. Yeah, juicy. I don't. By the way, if you're a parent who lets your daughter walk around with juicy written across the ass,
it'd be great if one of us got up and just had juicy on our ass.
Are you talking about this one?
Oh. Wait, excuse me.
So the claim was that she was protecting herself, right? And this was reported everywhere. Well, I think you already know that this one is false because there was more body cam footage that was released, and the girl in the pink jumpsuit. You may not have seen this clip though. Was talking with the police officers. Again, saying she came after me with a knife, she was coming after me with a knife. Here you go, here's the clip.
She came out at you with a knife earlier?
No, she just, that's what the police did.
That lady on the floor?
She came after me.
With a knife?
Yeah, so he got her. Can you please get my phone and stuff, please?
Have a seat for me, have a seat for me. Yes, we'll get it, we'll get everything.
Please, sir.
Hey, she doesn't seem to hate that cop.
No.
But I see some melanin there on screen. Could it be that he prevented her from being shanked?
I thought she was getting stabbed. She was very close.
Yeah, no, that's why it was what I call some good shooting.
Wow, that's well, but
mid stab.
Yeah, it was in the swing.
Yeah, it was in the swing.
Wow, that's obviously he should have gone for the legs. I think that's an important thing they're bringing up because everybody is a movie.
Shut her finger trigger.
You know, not everybody can have Lizzo legs that you can hit easily.
That's exactly true.
Usually a smaller target. Usually.
And this is also, look, you also have to go through this logically. Use the power of deduction. Let's rationalize this here. When they say, hold on a second, Micaiah was protecting herself with the knife. Now, we don't have all of the verification here. Some of these claims we can show are irrefutable. We know that they are 100% false. But you have to go through it logically. Hold on a second. I remember that footage. Wait, they were attacking her with a knife? But she was coming out of the house and she was lunging at them. And by the way, a knife is not a defensive weapon. When people say, I carry a knife to defend myself, you're an idiot. A knife is an assassination tool, or it's a tool to, you know, open your Amazon boxes, whatever it is.
Do some whittling.
A knife is not a defensive weapon, and she was charging someone else. That is not the behavior of someone who called the police. They seem to be waiting for the police. She did not, which brings us to our next claim. Micaiah, this was one that was reported everywhere, even here at NPR, the bastion of legitimate news. Micaiah is the one who called the cops, right? This is how it was reported. We even covered it yesterday. Well, turns out, if they'd have waited a little bit, the Columbus Police Department actually released the phone call. Here you go.
If these grown girls over here trying to fight us, trying to stab us, trying to put our hands on our grandma, get her now.
Yeah.
Trying to put their hands on
their grandma. Put their hands on us. And they hadn't identified the caller exactly, right, the police.
Yeah.
But we do know that, I think you can bring this overlay case, she had a knife and she was being stabby right there. That's what we were talking about.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah. The police officer stopped that stabbing right there. Or as the media said, she was holding a knife.
Well, right. Yes, of course.
Yes.
Where
she was holding a knife. Oh, she's buttering toast.
Well, Stephen, technically that's true. The media's just walking that line.
Look,
like, how can we say this in the least offensive way possible?
Yeah. They didn't say she was holding a knife while pinning the pink girl against the car.
But why do you... nobody wants to show up and kill anybody.
Yeah.
That's what I don't understand. Yeah. You're pushing this narrative that that's what the guy wanted to do. It's nonsense. No.
He came nobody up asking, like, what's happening?
Yeah, and he had to jump in. He had to do something. Do you want a cop to show up and go, look, I know she's stabbing you, but I don't want to come off as racist. I'd help you, but it's not my job.
Yeah, and the girl in pink is going, what about me? I'm black. He's like, well, you don't matter if you're the victim. Look, just ask Jacob Blake's broad.
You can tell she's 100 pounds healthier, and I don't want you to get COVID.
Right, exactly.
It just doesn't make sense. Like, nobody wants to see a girl like that. Nobody wants to see anybody die.
No.
For this cop to actually take somebody's life... anybody to take somebody's life is extremely traumatic and traumatizing. Yeah. Why would you assume...
for the cop.
Yes.
Yeah, for the cop. Yeah, this is honestly, he's the only one I feel... well, he's the one I feel worse for. I don't feel bad at all for the fact that the shooting happened. I would have felt worse had the girl been stabbed. Now, I get it. You know,
I don't
see
either,
people killed. Yeah, but I don't feel... it's one of those things, like George Floyd, of course, says that it's a tragedy. Breaks my heart. This doesn't. It would have broken my heart to see a girl get stabbed. Now, they said that she was the one who called the cops, Micaiah. This is how it was reported everywhere. Okay, let's go again through the logic process. Someone who calls the cops because they're being threatened. If she was the one who had called the cops saying they're trying to get me, why wasn't she in her room locking the door? Why wasn't she hiding? Why wasn't she sequestered, as the jury should be, but they often aren't? Why wasn't she taking... no, they were outside waiting for the cops, expecting the cops, talking with the cops, and she ran out and charged with a knife like she was fighting for Genghis Khan.
Well, and at the very least, why don't you run up to the cops and say, thank you, help, I'm here, 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 these are the bad guys, right? The cop is there, and she comes out.
I was going to get to it when I was finished my stabbing.
Oh. Got to take care of some stuff first.
I got stuff to do.
But who... what? Look. Who called? So that's the other girl's voice on the recording, correct?
It sounds like it.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like to me.
Okay. Not according to NPR. Take it at face value. It was Micaiah who called the cops. So here's another claim. Third claim that they made. And this one really, when I saw it, I said, we have to make sure that we address this. Because it just shows, again, inaccuracy. Because the aunt was really the only word when this initially started, right? Yeah. They took her testimony as fact. She was the one who made a lot of these claims. So when it was first reported, it was her aunt who was on the scene.
Okay.
Right? Well, then it changed yesterday to her dad and grandmother telling the aunt what actually happened.
Mm.
Right? And by the way, again, this is a report here, USA Today, just in case you didn't realize. It says holding a knife. This is another thing. She was holding a knife. Yeah. I was just holding a knife. That's like saying a mass shooter was holding a gun and you just write it. Or Lizzo was holding a spoon. Okay? She wasn't just holding a knife. She was actively committing a violent felony with said knife. The dad also was kicking someone on the ground, kicking the other girl
on the
ground.
Oh, was that the dad?
Yes. Yep.
I was about to say, who's the jerk that's trying to kick somebody in the head that's on the ground right in front of the cop? That's dad.
Yeah, that's just my old man.
Something about apples and trees on this one.
So Micaiah's dad is kicking a girl in the head?
Yes. Yeah, the one that was on the ground.
He looks rather young to me.
Well, let's not
Could
get
be
into that.
Kicking a minor in the head.
Yeah. By the way, I love the fact check that you just brought up. If you saw there, right below, they were like, hey, people are saying the knife was on the ground, and that is inaccurate.
That was another thing.
It was just in the hand.
It was in her hand while she was swinging.
You feel like you've done your job now?
That's USA Today's false virtue signal. It's like, listen, a lot of places are reporting that she dropped the knife before she was shot just because the aunt said it, who wasn't there, but that was at NPR, and that was at Daily Beast and CNN and MSNBC. But we have more integrity than that here at USA Today. We do believe, but unconfirmed, she was holding a knife.
No one has ever been mid-stab and been like, oh, geez.
Yes.
Watch
Louder with Crowder live, Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.